In this tutorial, you will add data from a variety of sources to assess the impact of potential flooding in Wellington, New Zealand. You will add a web layer, a feature class, a shapefile, and a raster. First, you will add data from the Living Atlas. The elevation and bathymetry category will help filter our search for a hillshade we will add to the map. By default, the extent is constrained by the local New Zealand map projection that has been set for the map. The World Ocean Base Map has some transparency. We can get a nice effect by moving the hillshade underneath the ocean base map. Now let's use the previous extent to quickly return to Wellington. We'll add another boundaries layer containing labels from the Living Atlas to help identify the area we will be looking at. We'll also add some transparency and change the visibility range so the labels will only show in beyond the specified scale. Now let's take a closer look at our Wellington data. In the project geodatabase, we'll add a suburbs layer and zoom to its extent. The symbology is covering the map, so let's change the symbol fill to no color. You can add data from any folder that you connect to, and this project comes with a folder connection. From here, we will add our flood zone shapefile. The shapefile is covering our suburb boundary, so let's move it below. The default symbology for our flood zone could also be more representative. Let's change it to blue and remove the outline. Zooming in will give us a better view of the data. To visualize the data in 3D, let's copy the flood zone layer from the 2D map and paste it into the 3D scene. To get a better sense of how water flows and accumulates in a flood risk zone, we'll add a slope layer. The symbology could be improved here too. Let's change the black and white to a more conventional color scheme. Now let's change the perspective and look at our scene up close. From this view, it looks like a flood would affect most of the buildings in the foreground. The second view shows how floodwater may flow through the landscape at the eastern end of the suburb. We now have a map and scene with a variety of data from different locations. For detailed instructions, follow the written tutorial in the ArcGIS Pro help.